and have had one foot in 5D while holding the other in third. However, some may find themselves being drawn back to third for a short period of time. Why on earth would you ever want to re-enter the Matrix after having a taste of the good life? If you have been struggling outside of the Matrix, this may be one of the most important articles you can read right now. We are all doing the best we can in this tumultuous time of change that has long been foretold of. While watching so many people fall into dire straits, we continue to do our work on ourselves and try to act by the golden rule. If you're like me, you have recently realized that you have had to fling yourself back into the Matrix for a short period of time in order to tie up some loose ends. The trick to navigating this life is to use the Matrix for what you need it for while striving towards the complete dissolution of what is not serving humanity. If this happened to you, I am here to assure you that you have not regressed yourself out of ascension. Walking back in third feels like crawling through thick, black sludge. After it is all said and done, it is actually a great step toward progression. Some people have found themselves struggling to exist outside of the Matrix, which is ironic because if you are suffering, then it makes it hard to reach the 5D energies. There seems to be a prompting at this time on a subconscious level to take care of the things that we have not wanted to face or have been putting off, hoping for a great change to happen outside in the real world. Lately, I have talked to people that have been intrepid or undecided about certain monetary or life decisions because of the prophesized ascension future. Have you kept your money out of the bank because of the discussions about the financial collapse? Have you decided not to file tax returns because you know there is no law requiring it? Maybe you hope property taxes would just go away? Have you put off selling a house because your retirement investment is better off in real estate than in the bank? By making one or many of these choices, we can become limited in the way that we can move through the maze of the Matrix. In fact, it can actually drag us down into depression or hardship if we refuse to work in the Matrix or use the monetary system. While it is admirable for those who want to live off of the grid and grow their own food, the reality for most people is that in order to focus on their spiritual growth, they require organic grocery stores, air conditioning, and modern-day conveniences like hot running water and dishwashers. For one example, if you have all of your money under your mattress instead of in the bank, it may be hard to rent a house or apartment to put a roof over your head because the system is set up to make sure you have either proof of income or enough funds in the bank to cover your lease. If you don't already own a house and you don't have proof of income, it becomes extremely hard to provide a roof over your head for you or your family. If you have a house that has been weighing you down, or you have felt like it is time for a change of cities, you may have worked yourself into a problem. You may have to put some of your money back into the bank in order to use the system without being in fear of your government stealing your money. It is my opinion that it is certainly acceptable at this time to have a portion of your funds in a bank account tied to auto-paying your bills. If using an automated system takes your mind off of the Matrix long enough to enjoy the now moment, it's well worth it. After all, if the system crashes, we will all be screwed together for a short period of time. Another example is the notion that we should all revert to living like survivormen. As a human on Earth in the year 2017, we all deserve abundance and convenience if we choose it. After all, many of us are used to replicators in our fancy spaceships. You can certainly make the choice to do the best you can with the world we live in. Things haven't changed overnight, and for the time being, you can only do what makes you the happiest so that you can focus on your responsibilities and life purpose. If you have been feeling pressure to move off the grid and revert to living in the 1800s, you can take a deep breath and live with what feels right to you and what will make you most comfortable while being as environmentally and socially responsible as possible without suffering. What I have decided is that I did not come here to starve to death in case of the trucks not delivering to the grocery stores, but I also did not come here to become a farmer. Personally, I have decided that if there is a permanent break in the food chain, I will be done with my life here on this planet and will return to whence I came. With this being said, I do have a month's worth of survival food to keep me comfortable or to barter with. Past that, I will decide whether or not to continue. My point is that to not plan for the future out of fear. I began prepping in 2012 and have thrown away hundreds of dollars of expired foods I kept for survival. While it may seem like you are going against the rules of where your attention goes, energy flows, lowering yourself back down into the matrix in order to provide for your basic needs or to clear up hauntings of the past will actually propel you further into your highest probable future timeline. It really does help you to be in the now moment, not tied down to the past or worried about the future, even if it is still within the matrix. We are here to shift third from the lowest part of the base upward, and in order to do that we needed to know what it felt like to be free for a while. Now with a higher consciousness and more patience, we are able to tackle the things that we have put off that deal with households, legalities, and finance. These include, going through your material items and lightening your load. Give them to charity to be repurposed or throw some things away. Yes, it is okay to contribute to the landfill one last time. You are going to change the way you buy material items in the future to where you are not so careless, to where you will never contribute to the trash like you did before. Selling a house or moving to a new city. You may have been one who put off listing your house for fear of what the markets will do. Or perhaps you didn't want to take a loss and thought you would wait for the markets to go back up. If this is weighing you down tremendously, it is best to free yourself of it now and live for today, not for the future. Also, don't live for someone else's needs or material attachments. Changing jobs, even if it is taking a job in the matrix industry. As long as you are not harming the planet or others, there are ways to remove the negative energy psychologically tied to money or a particular industry, as well as ways to bring light into the industry by immersing yourself into it. At the current time, we use money as our exchange method and we can focus on weaning ourselves to something else, but we still have to eat and have a roof over our heads in order to positively contribute to the collective consciousness. If you do not have a job and you are unhappy, or if you have a job and you don't like it, it's up to you to do something about it. If you need to temporarily take a job inside of the matrix system, do not feel guilty or unsuccessful spiritually. More than likely it will only be a temporary means of support that will open the door to something better. The key is to be happy in what you do for an energy exchange. Taking breaks from relationships so each person can work on themselves or some of these issues mentioned, or starting a new relationship. People change, vibrations change. Sometimes we need some time alone or a change of pace in order to make a relationship flourish again. Some people are releasing one relationship which opens the door for a better match. The legalities of divorce are horrible, but once it is all over with, it is very freeing and you realize how marriage was one big legal control to begin with. You learn to make different choices in the future that allow for growth between two people. Finishing up multiple projects in order to focus on one or two instead of too many. Who has a list a mile long of things to do? Now is the time to prioritize the ones that you have been dreading so that you can give your time to those that will help you move towards a better future. Taking a rest from the alternative media overload. It is very likely at this time that many people are on brain overload and just need to stop listening to everything and go inside for deep communion with the higher self. Take it a few days off of the internet, or maybe even a week's break of not thinking about anything metaphysical, truth-seeking, or spiritual at all. Yes, you read that right. Try it, see how it makes you feel. Go camping or immerse yourself in a third movie, a comedy, love story, or something lighthearted. And go ahead and cry if you feel like it. Upon learning that all comes from the one infinite source, realizing the need to stop invocating protection in substitution for owning the light and darkness within you. Transmutation versus avoidance right now is a key. Face your darkest fears and see how liberating it leaves you. Saying that you need protection shows that you are not standing in your sovereignty as a co-creator of this reality. Joining in third community with the asleep ones in order to share your vibration. This means no longer being a hermit for fear of others bringing you down. You've had long enough to prepare yourself and now your light and vibration is needed. You are the boots on the ground. Eating ice cream every now and then or your favorite treat. In moderation, and organic if possible. It won't kill you as there are many other worse things on the planet designed for killing humanity. We are also here to live as a human being and to enjoy what this lifetime has to experience. Sometimes we have to just throw out the rules for a moment and live like a kid again. This may be seen as the final return into the third matrix in order to prepare for your new role after the long-awaited event occurs. Everyone wants to know what the event is and when it will occur. In my opinion, it will happen when we make it happen. It will happen when we do all of the rest of the work necessary in our lives to free us up for being able to do our new job. In other words, how many of you could pick up and relocate on a moment's notice in order to serve? That may be a little drastic as an example, but the point is that many people have so many threads tying them down that it has just become too overwhelming to begin to work on it and they have been waiting for a miracle to occur in order to free them. Miracles are real, but they can't occur if we are blocking them. Also remember, not everything in the matrix is out to get you. Taking care of your past commitments allows you to be more focused on your now, which will open portals for higher levels of connection. Now is the time to take care of your responsibilities. While it may take some blood, sweat, and tears now, you'll feel much lighter in the end and will be ready for anything the universe calls you to do. Many of us have no idea what we are really clearing on a multidimensional level when we roll up our sleeves and get to work in our third illusion. If you are one who is not suffering outside of the matrix, then I encourage you to keep on shining. For those who have to dig deeper and darker, know that it's okay to open the third closet to revisit your skeletons for good. Let's hope this is the last return, and collectively, if we all take care of our responsibilities once and for all, we can continue to move forward at a faster pace.